One thing we do want to ask you about while we've got you today is actually Indian IPOs. So I know you've been doing a bit of research in this area, and issuance, money raised through issuance, has surpassed the past 3 years. How has this been possible through the pandemic? What are you seeing in the pipeline?
So thanks for asking, because we just have a fresh piece out today. It's something we've been working on for a while, and we're actually very, very excited about it. And the larger point here, and this is a bigger conceptual theme than just sort of where the market's going to go in the next few months, is that there's a so-called digital transformation that's taking place in India. And the data that we've looked at suggests that there could be something like 150 companies that could be coming public or the potential to come public over the next, say, 3 years that could alone raise $400 billion of market cap. We think that could drive India's aggregate market cap from 3.5 trillion currently to about 5 trillion in, say, 3-4 years. That would make it rise from the seventh largest market globally to the fifth largest. It would take its weight in the emerging market indices from 12% to 15%. And we would see the weight of the new economy in the market go from currently 5% to perhaps as much as 15%. So what we're really flagging here is that as exciting as China was over the last decade, when you had this new China story, which was very, very profitable and successful for investors, we could see some sort of an analog of that beginning to take place in India. And that renders us quite excited about their prospects.
Yeah, it's really interesting to have this story just at the back of what we're seeing happening in China with equities. Perhaps we see investors kind of positioning themselves around more to India if they read your report and go with it. What kind of impact is this having on the equity indices mix in India, having all these new entrants?
Well, that's exactly it. So currently, the so-called new economy part of the index is still fairly small. I mean, one of the comparators that we did, and this shows just how significant the transformation in China has been. If you just look at the average age of listing of all the different markets, all the different stocks and the different exchanges across Asia, you'll see that most of them have an average listing age of somewhere around 20 years. For India, it's about 21. China is by far the youngest index, which currently is about an average listing age of 9 years, which shows the amount of innovation and new companies that have been added to the index. And you think about what the composition of China's index is today versus 10 years ago. Obviously, you've got companies like Tencent, Alibaba, and JD, and Pinduoduo, which just were not part of the index 10 years ago. So we think a similar thing is starting to happen in India, where the listing of new economy companies will start to transform the index, and we will go from about a 5% new economy weighting to perhaps something as high as 15% in the next 3 or 4 years, and not stopping there, probably rising further.